Hello, in this video I'm going to show how to calculate the CO2 absorption of a group of plants in a landscape project, and I will use LandsDesign for Rhino for inserting different plant species in the project, and Grasshopper to run the analysis of the CO2 absorption data. In this document, I have already Grasshopper running in the background with the Grasshopper definition that does this analysis. I will start by inserting a plant, a single plant, and later on we will see this analysis running in a larger project. So I will run the plant command in LandsDesign. I'm going to browse in the plant database. And here I have already created a group of plant species that I have marked as favorites that I know this calculator works with. Basically, these are the species whose CO2 absorption data has been already gathered. I can explore for any of these species, and I'm gonna select, for example, Acer platanitis. I define the insert parameters and insert it in the model. As soon as I have inserted this plant, we can see this graph in the top viewport, which is generated by Grasshopper. This graph indicates the evolution of the CO2 absorption of all the species we have the CO2 absorption data. And we can see highlighted in red the species that we have inserted in that model. The x-axis indicates the period of years of this calculation, and in the y-axis we can see the amount of CO2 absorption data measured in tons. Right now we are measuring the CO2 absorption data of this plant from the 0 to the 18 years, and we can see here the result. But let's take a look at the Grasshopper definition. So I'm going to open Grasshopper. And here I already have the list of species this calculator works with. And here you can find the source that has provided this CO2 absorption data. It's the Spanish Ministry for the Ecological Transition and the Demographic Challenge. And all this data is available on the web. Here, in the input data, we can define the period in which we want to run this analysis, which can be made for a certain number of years before or after the current date. So here, we can define if these years correspond to a period before the current date or after the current date. Here, in this blue panel, we can see the results of the CO2 absorption data, which is always an estimated data. Also, we can define the current age at the date of the analysis. So for example, we can define that this Acer platanitis will be measured when it's already 6 years old. And we can see also how this graph has moved. So if we change the number of years of this analysis, we'll see how this endpoint moves, and we can see also the results updating life. If we take a look at this definition, we can see here in this panel all the values of the absorption data measured after 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40 years with the name of the species. These values have been ordered in a way that will let us generate this graph. Now, let's see what happens when we insert more species here. So I'm going to run the row command. I'm going to select another species. Like this one. Here we can define the row parameters and draw the row like a spline. When we insert this new species, we can see here a new graph with the corresponding values. And here we can define the initial age of this species in the moment of the analysis. If we check the results, we can see the number of units of each species, the amount of CO2 absorption of each species, and the total estimated accumulated absorptions. Now we can see this grasshopper definition working on a larger project. And here we've got several plant species arranged in forest, rows, or individually, for example. We have already here a plant list that indicates the number of species and the total amount of units of each species. If we open Grasshopper with this definition, we can see already the results of each one of the species, the total accumulated absorption of CO2, and the totals here in that blue panel. If we take a look at the top viewport, we can see this graph with all the species that are involved in this project. Here we can change the period of calculation years. We can see how this value updates. And we can define the initial age of each of the species by editing these parameters. Now, if we change some parameters of the species in this project, we will be able to see how this affects the results of the CO2 absorption data. For example, I'm going to change the species of this plant. For an Abies alba. Or we will change the amount of plants we got in this forest. If we open Grasshopper again, we'll see how these CO2 absorption results have changed.